the stage with our production Mark today to take a bow.
It's funny you should ask. Because, of course, we couldn't go without doing the one thing I've been waiting to do all night, which is get every trumpeter in the room on stage at once. Please welcome back all our friends from the ITG and the trumpet section, and we're all going to... Come on, guys, come on out.
If you could take the keyboard away, that'd be great.
We'll just take a sec to get the stands organised here, because what we're going to do is put them where they should be. It was lovely when they were all up the back before, wasn't it? All the trumpeters, it looked great. All wrong. Trumpeters should be out the front. All of us. I'm sorry to do this to you, Mark. You're the only one we can't get in front of because we need to see you. So you're going to have to deal with it, yeah, if you can. You can't hear me, no, because you've got earplugs in, I know, yes. He has. No, it's a bit... you probably don't realise this, but there is a statutory distance you must stand by law from a trumpet when it's being blown at full volume. I'm making that up. But there should be. And when you get, about 20 trumpets, that distance would mean that Mark would probably have to stand somewhere just up there. So he's got the earplugs in, he'll be quite safe. What piece would you do if you're going to get 20 trumpeters on stage with the Sydney Symphony? Well, there's a piece that nearly all trumpeters have played at some stage. It's one of those, you know, it's almost like a party piece, something that we can all join in, and it has different sections in it for all of us. And it goes quite quickly. And I don't know why, but might be something to do with the trumpet, but it's quite an extroverted song too. So it's a piece by Leroy Anderson. And we'll get the firsts over here. We've got, welcome back, Jeff. You haven't got that silly little trumpet anymore, have you? Got the real one? Good. All right. None of that rivalry. There is a sort of a bit of folklore or myth about trumpet that trumpeters have a lot of rivalry between them. It's not true. And they make those jokes, you know, like, how many trumpeters does it take to change a light globe? Do you know that one? Yeah. Four. One to change the light globe and three to stand there and say, I could have done it higher. But it's not true. We're all colleagues here. Just don't anyone get in my way. Okay, so this is a piece that if it works, because this is dangerous... It's written for three trumpets. This is a piece that if it works, it's called the Bugler's Holiday. If it doesn't, it's called the Bungler's Retreat.
Thank you.
The sound of 20 trumpeters surrounding conductor Mark today on the stage here at the Sydney Opera House, led, of course, by James Morrison, has had an incredibly busy evening here in this concert, which has ranged from Janacek all the way through to Tijuana Brass, an extraordinary range of music written for the trumpet across the ages, accompanied by the Sydney Symphony Orchestra and also by James Morrison's band. We had James Muller playing guitar, Cameron Undy, the bass player, and drummer Gordon Rittmeister. And the Sydney Symphony leaving the stage now, which is a pretty good sign that there's not going to be any more music tonight. And after that, what could there be? That Bugler's Holiday by Leroy Anderson. That's it from us tonight. Thanks to the ABC Classic FM team here. Sound engineer tonight was Andrew Dixon, and the producer was Andre Shrimsky. I'm Guy Noble, and it's good night from the Concert Hall of the Sydney Opera House.